These wrestling matches are sanctioned by the International Wrestling Alliance, supervised by the rules and regulations of the Illinois State Athletic Commission, and promoted by Fred Kohler. The officials assigned for tonight's card are the attending physician, Dr. Douglas Rodriguez, the timekeeper, Phil Weideman, the referees, Pedro Ramos and Frank Ellis. The first contest on tonight's card will be a two out of an Australian tag team match with six men, two out of three falls with a 60-minute time limit. Featuring from Benton Harbor, Michigan, weighing 276 pounds, Bobo, Brazil. Brazil! His partner from Madison, Wisconsin, weighing 254 pounds, Art Thomas. Team from Jamaica, British West Indies, weighing 216 pounds, Dory Dixon. Dixon. Their opponents in this match, from Hollywood, California, weighing 230 pounds, handsome Johnny Barend. Another team partner also from Hollywood, California, weighing 220 pounds, magnificent Maurice. Maurice. The third man on the team from Camden, New Jersey, weighing 243 pounds, Buddy Rogers. Rogers. The referee, Frank Ellis, two out of three falls, 60-minute time limit.
Well, I don't envy referee Frank Ellis his job in this match. Six-man tag. And we can look forward to all kinds of mayhem and action like you haven't seen for a long time. On one team, Dory Dixon, Seaman Art Thomas, Bobo Brazil. Their opponents, Buddy Rogers, handsome Johnny Barend, and magnificent Maurice. The latter three on the right as you look at your screen, plotting something as they had their heads together very closely there. Dory Dixon will start for his team. And magnificent Maurice is in there for his. Dory Dixon very, very fast, known as the Calypso Kid from Jamaica. Johnny Barend stormed into the ring after apparently getting the tag, but referee Frank Ellis didn't allow it. Made them tag all over. Handsome Johnny Barend. He called and he went pole vaulting, or high jumping if you will, over the ropes. He doesn't like it, as the Calypso Kid made him look a little foolish on that one. The kid is 216 pounds, been in this country for a couple of years, very fast. Oh boy, he moves like a shadow. Well, we've got this threesome arguing among themselves. Buddy Rogers, very unhappy, calls Johnny Barend over to him. Barend looks somewhat frightened of Buddy. I don't know why. I guess he doesn't want to get the comeuppance, which Buddy indicated he'd like to give him. Buddy pulling the old motion of pointing to his head, use your head. He calls out to Johnny. Well, I'll tell you, we can look forward to seeing all six of these guys in the ring. I tell you, it's going to happen. And when it does, I think I'm just going to close my mouth or I'll blow my top. Frank Ellis waving Barend away, and a quick move by the Calypso Kid, Dory Dixon. Wound up with Barend in the corner. Boy, the referee could use six pair of eyes on the top and the bottom of his head on each side and front and back. This six-man tag, two out of three falls with a 60-minute time limit. By Dory Dixon. Well-built, in excellent physical condition, moves fast and light, and so far has been carrying the battle for his team. Seaman R. Thomas and Bobo Brazil very contentedly watching the action from outside the ring. So far, haven't deemed it necessary to do more than just watch and enjoy. As this threesome, on your right as you watch the screen, still seem to be arguing among themselves. I don't know if they've got their signals down, Pat. Magnificent Maurice from Hollywood, California, 230 pounds. Has been wrestling 12 years, took a hard blow, got the tag over to Buddy Rogers, and Buddy is in there now with Dory Dixon. And this is rough treatment that Dixon can look forward to, but he's mad. Oh, and Buddy Rogers figured it was time to let somebody else carry the battle, and it's handsome Johnny Barend in there and not too happy about it. Dory Dixon leaping into the air, brought that elbow down hard on a stunned Johnny Barend, who weaved his way to the wrong corner and took some bruising elbow punishment from Bobo Brazil, who towered over him. Johnny Barend, only too happy to get out of the ring, got that tag to Buddy Rogers, and when Buddy saw Bobo Brazil coming in, he got out. Refuses the tag. He doesn't want any part of it. Johnny Barend slinging off the ropes. And a Coco Bond once again by Bobo Brazil. And Bobo figures he'd let Seaman R. Thomas in there. Oh, that vicious bear hug. Absolutely fantastic, ladies and gentlemen, here at Wrestling Champions, as these six tremendous wrestlers has this crowd on his feet, and there's a turnabout as Buddy Rogers brought Seaman R. Thomas off the ropes, got the pin in a fantastic turnabout, and now into the ring, and Mike O'Brien for the official decision and time of that fall.
5 minutes and 45 seconds with a backflip. The winner of the first team fall, the team of Rogers, Barend, and Maurice.
There you have it, fans. The winners of the first team fall between the team of Rogers, handsome Johnny Barend, and magnificent Maurice. They're the winners over Seaman R. Thomas, Bobo Brazil, and Dory Dixon. There's the bell for the start of this second fall in this six-man tag. This is two out of three falls with a 60-minute time limit. That's Bobo Brazil in the ring for his team, and Johnny Barend in for his. That first fall won in a surprising turnabout, very, very fast, by the fabulous Buddy Rogers. I don't know if he was playing possum, but he refused the tag a number of times, scooted out of the ring as fast as he went in a couple of times. But boy, when the chips were down, he caught Seaman R. Thomas unawares and got that pin on him with a beautiful backflip. Seaman R. Thomas in there momentarily after the tag, calls for help from Bobo Brazil, who's in there now against Johnny Barend, who's been in from the beginning for his team. Things have been moving so rapidly, we've been unable to fill you in on some of the background of these men. We'll try, if possible. Buddy Rogers has been the world champion, winning it in 1961 at Comiskey Park from Pat O'Connor. We had the pleasure and privilege of describing that match. And a dandy it was, too. Bobo Brazil with those flying head scissors, rolling Johnny Barend to the mat. Magnificent Maurice into the ring to help, was bringing a hard stomp down on Bobo Brazil, who rolled out of the way right in the nick of time, and that stomp went right across the chest of Johnny Barend, and of our surprise wrestler you never did see. Buddy Rogers motions for Maurice to get in there and spell Johnny Barend. Bobo Brazil still carrying the banner for his team. Well, there you saw it again. This time it was Johnny Barend who was outfoxed by Bobo Brazil as that forearm blow was misdirected and landed almost on the chopper of Magnificent Maurice, who didn't look so magnificent that time. We've got Dory Dixon in the ring for his team. From Jamaica, known as the Calypso Kid, 216 pounds. Been wrestling professionally for 8 years. He's 27 years old. Tied for first place in the 1954 Olympics in weightlifting. Uses the Jamaica flying block. Has wrestled here at the Coliseum several times. And has really caught the fancy of the crowds. Magnificent Maurice from Hollywood, a very colorful guy in the ring, wears a cape, sunglasses. Right now he's scrambling out. He had too much from the Calypso Kid, but now he's back in on the tag as the Kid bounces down with that elbow, dancing up onto the ropes and down, and a beautiful body drop across Magnificent Maurice for the pin. Some you never did see. And now into the ring, and Mike O'Brien for the official decision and time of that fall.
5 minutes and 55 seconds for the body fall. The team of Thomas, Curry, and Brazil. One fall each.
There you have it, fans. The winners of the second team fall between the team of Seaman R. Thomas, Bobo Brazil, and Dory Dixon, and Buddy Rogers, Magnificent Maurice, and Handsome Johnny Barend. The winner, the Calypso Kid, Bobo Brazil, and Seaman R. Thomas. And the bell sounds for the start of the second fall, or rather the third fall. Boy, I'm as excited as this crowd, and maybe even more so. That screaming you hear is directed at Buddy Rogers, who likes nothing better than to draw the yells and the ire of the crowd, and he did it that time, challenging one and all to come on up to the ring. In the ring, the Calypso Kid, Dory Dixon, with Magnificent Maurice. Boy, that flying drop kick of Dory Dixon's is a thing of beauty. He gets the tag now from Seaman R. Thomas from Madison, 32 years old, has been wrestling in the pro ranks for about 5 years, played basketball in high school. He's tall, he's strong, 240 pounds, 6 feet 5 inches tall. Came in second in the Mr. Wisconsin bodybuilding contest in 1954. His rise in professional wrestling has been fantastic. Probably has as tremendous a physique as you'll see in wrestling. Very powerful. Watch him take on both these men, Magnificent Maurice and handsome Johnny Barend. And you saw them sprawl across the ring as Seaman R. Thomas brought that tremendous power to bear on both of them and flipped them as if they were half their actual size. Buddy Rogers trying to rally his forces. This is a crucial time, and they can't afford to be disorganized now. It's one fall apiece. Buddy Rogers won the first fall. The Calypso Kid, Dory Dixon, won the second fall for their respective teams. This is the third and deciding fall in this six-man tag match. And a tremendous match it has been. This crowd has been screaming at the top of its lungs right from the opening bell, and so is yours truly. This is George Brenard at ringside here at the Coliseum in Chicago. Boy, oh boy, Buddy Rogers caught that drop kick in the kisser. And Johnny Barend caught that elbow in his. There's Buddy Rogers off the ropes with that flying knee drop off the ropes across the back of Dory Dixon, who's in great pain. The referee disqualified Buddy Rogers and his team. We've got all six men in the ring. Mayhem in the ring, and this crowd on its feet. Every single one of them. Buddy Rogers on the apron, out of the ring. Johnny Barend out of the ring. Magnificent Maurice is out of the ring. Triumphant trio, Bobo Brazil, Dory Dixon, and Seaman R. Thomas, very happy. And now into the ring, and Mike O'Brien for the official decision and time of that fall and match.
In 4 minutes and 40 seconds on a disqualification, the winners, Bobo Brazil, R. Thomas, and Dory Dixon.
Winners of that third team fall in the match between the team of Dory Dixon, Bobo Brazil, Seaman R. Thomas, and the team of Rogers, Barend, and Magnificent Maurice. The winners are Dory Dixon, Bobo Brazil, and Seaman R. Thomas. Absolutely tremendous in this ring, and I've just about lost my match, and we've got my voice, and we've got another match to go.
I'm sorry,
I
indeed.
Guess you want to catch your breath, too.
I'm used to it, and you know, I could do this all over again, because, you see, when you train hard enough, you can do things the superhuman body tries to do and cannot do it, but while training, it's much different. All I want is a marketing promoter to give me a match with Buddy Rogers anytime, anywhere. He's right here in Chicago. And let's see how come it'll be. That's all I want. You know,
I think that would be tremendous. You want to step forward just a little bit here, Dory?
Pleasure indeed.
Dory, in that first fall, if you'll remember it now, the first fall in tonight's match, you fellas, you and Bobo and Seaman seemed to be doing very, very well. And all of a sudden, Buddy Rogers came in here, and there was a quick turnabout, and he caught Seaman R. Thomas and got that fall with a backflip.
Unfortunately,
do you know what happened there?
Well,
it happened
it was so
fast, I didn't even catch
it. I really understand it, really. But still, I can tell you for myself personally that if I get Rogers just for a match with me only, you know, just both of us here in Chicago, for Mr. Colonel, you know, I think something else. I'm very tired, actually, you know.
Speech. Tell me this. Have you ever met Buddy Rogers before?
I met him, and he always keeps running away.
He does?
Yes. I wrestled him in Madison Square Garden with a sellout crowd over there. and it was, what do you call, 90 minutes draw, you know. And when the last part, he jumped out of the ring and went away. Just like that, for no reason at all.
You mean he just ran away from the
match? He just ran away from the match.
It was, how long did you wrestle him?
We wrestled 90 minutes.
90 minutes.
Si.
Fantastic. Here, listen, I'm going to let you go. Dory Dixon, thank you very much. You go in and get a shower.
Pleasure.
Thank you, Dory Dixon.
Only.